September 2017, we're doing TESOL course here.
Hi, John.
Hi.
How are you today?
Good.
Great. So where are you from, John?
From Miami, Florida.
Wow.
USA.
Great. I'd love to go to Miami someday. So how long have you been here in Thailand already?
I've been here 2 years.
2 years?
Yeah, over 2 years. It's going to be more like 3 now.
Wow, that's quite a while.
Yes.
Okay. So, about this course, what do you enjoy the most during the course, taking the course?
I like all the material that the teachers gave us. They were always there for us.
Okay.
To let us know and explain how to look at this program from a teacher's point of view. And that's important because as a student, you always look at it from a student point of view. And we flip it.
Sure.
We flip it. So that makes you, I think it can make you a better student.
Alright, so that's probably one of your difficulties as well. I mean, here, taking the course.
Yeah, I found difficult, and I think a lot of us found a little bit of difficulties on preparing materials for the classes, like making our own
materials,
yeah, our own lessons. Yeah, because it's very time consuming, and then you have a lot of papers to write, and if you fall behind, then it's like,
it's a lot to catch up.
Yeah. It's overwhelming when you have to catch up like that. So I try to keep everything up to date, writing all weekend long.
Yeah, so it takes a lot of time.
Yes.
During the week. How come or where have you heard about this course?
I found this course online like a year ago.
A year ago?
Yeah, and I was having some other projects in the works, like an art show and things like that. So I came here and I met Stephen.
Mm-hmm.
And I always do my research when I do business with anyone.
Yeah.
You know.
That is common.
Yeah, these days,
okay.
You know, with all the scams and stuff.
Yeah.
So I came here and I spoke with him, and he was very knowledgeable about everything and explained to me how the program was. And then I left, and like 6 months went by, 7 months went by, till I finally was able to finish my other project and dedicate all my time to this, because it is a compacted program, which means that there is a lot of material very fast.
But what made you decide to, you know, take the course?
Well, it was pretty much talking with Stephen, and I asked a lot of questions, and he answered everything for me, so I made my choice with
based on his.
Yeah, based on his, yeah.
His,
yes.
Okay, not bad. What advice would you give to anybody who considers taking this course as well?
If they want to do it, to really have the time to do this, first of all, 100% commitment, and to do the homework. Don't fall behind.
So, time, effort.
Time and effort, yes.
Passion?
And passion. Yes, you have to like being a teacher.
Okay. In order to teach?
Yeah, because, teaching, for me, like, I went to the field trips, and mm-hmm. I loved working with the kids. It was awesome. I think we all enjoyed that.
Mm-hmm.
And, but teaching is not for everyone.
Yeah, so you gotta make sure you have all these qualities.
Yes, I think the school was very clear when they sent me an email. They asked me questions like, why do you want to become a teacher? And things like that. It makes you think to, you know, to go back and kind of like double check. Yes, and think about it.
Alright, and what do you plan to do after you finish the course?
I want to take a break for like a week.
Reasonable.
Take a break for a week. Go to the gym.
Mm-hmm.
Go to my Thai massage.
Oh,
and I'm gonna. Then I have an interview next week. So
at a school. Or?
Yeah. I'm going to see a school for web design and programming. in English, teaching web design and programming in English. So I'm gonna go see what they have to offer, take a look at the program, and see if I can teach it.
Okay. Well, good luck with that.
And thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you again for this interview.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. So, Han, how are you today?
Fine, thanks.
Do you mind telling us where you're from?
I'm from South London, but I was born in Paris.
Oh, wow. Interesting. So, how long have you been here already in Thailand?
I've been in Thailand for 2 months.
2 months long. So, what do you enjoy the most on this course?
I enjoy the most learning about the new different teaching techniques that we're then going to use in our evening practice classes.
After the course and after. And have you encountered any difficulties during the course?
Difficulties or things I didn't really like were the young learners things. And okay. Things with young learners I found a bit more difficult. I just couldn't.
To handle on.
I didn't enjoy it as much.
Oh, okay. That's great. And how did you hear about the course, like this TESOL course?
I was just browsing online for things of this nature to do in Bangkok, and I happened to stumble across TESOL.
Coincidence,
yeah.
See. And would you mind telling us how you decided to take this specific course?
I went on the website.
Okay.
And I looked through the different, you know, requirements and what they would teach us. And through the members, the trainers, anything that they said they'll provide us with. And I just thought that it was going to be a good course to join.
Might be a good idea. Okay. So what advice would you give anyone who consider coming to Thailand to teach this course?
Advice, I would say to enjoy it. Because if you don't enjoy it, then it's no point, because there's a lot of work and forward to do. And also just to dedicate yourself to this. It's only 1 month, but there's a lot to do, and you have to give most of your attention to it.
So passion and effort.
Yeah.
Okay, that's about right. What do you plan to do after you graduate from this course?
I was planning to leave Bangkok and just go back to the south of Thailand.
To travel?
Yeah, and find a job somewhere in the south. I think I'm going to stay in Bangkok, possibly.
For a while?
Yeah. For at least, say, 6 months.
Alright, see you. Thank you again for this interview.
Thanks,
you.
You're welcome.
Yeah. Hello, Doug.
Hello.
How are you today?
Pretty good, how are you?
Good. Would you mind telling us where you're from?
Sure. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri.
Oh, Missouri. Lovely. I have a friend from there too. Cool. So, how about you tell us about the course? What do you enjoy most when I was here? TESOL course.
I think I enjoyed the, I would say the teaching the most.
The teaching?
Yeah, I like teaching at night, predominantly. I would say that the hands-on part of the course is my favorite.
Alright, interesting. And what difficulties have you encountered since you were here, like during the course?
I would say the feedback has been kind of hard for me, because I've always been hard on myself, so when people give feedback, it's like you did something wrong, but really it's just trying to make you better.
Okay. Wow. And how did you hear about this course?
My friend who actually came here with.
So you're doing it together?
Too, yeah.
Oh, I see. So you come together. And, but how do you guys decide to take this course?
I'm not sure.
Okay, you just, why not?
Yeah, just for adventure. Just came here for adventure.
Alright, not bad. And anyhow, what advice would you give anyone who considered taking this course?
Just keep trying. You're going to want to quit every now and then.
It's hard, right?
Yeah, it's really hard. But
you haven't quit?
No, God, but no. I wanted to a couple times.
So what are your plans after, you know, when you finish this course? What do you plan to do or to go?
I plan on just getting experience as quickly as possible, no matter where it is, teaching wise.
So basically you just
get out there, get out as quickly as possible, and then see where it goes from there.
Alright. That's how long have you been here already?
I guess about 5 weeks now.
5 weeks in Thailand. How is it so far?
It's good. It's different. Lots of different food, lots of traffic here. But
yeah,
I like it.
Cool. Glad to hear it. So, tell me about the courses here. The course. What difficulties have you encountered during the course?
It's very fast-paced. So sometimes, if you get a little bit behind, it can be really stressful and hard to get back on track. Yeah, other than that, it's just keeping up with the pace and trying to learn and take notes and do your reflections every day can be a little tough.
I see. Yeah, it's a one-month course.
Mm-hmm.
What about things you enjoy the most during the course here?
I really enjoyed the nights where we got to teach, like the adults or the kids. It was, you know, like a real life experience, and it gave me some really good practice for going to school or wherever I go and teaching after this. I think that was my favorite part, was like the actual practice teaching.
Yeah, like in the actual environment.
Yeah.
Great. So how did you come across the course itself? Like, where did you hear it?
Actually, it was through a friend back home. She was thinking of doing this, and she sent me the link, and went ahead and checked it out and decided it sounds pretty good. So.
Basically, you come with not a friend, you come with Doug.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But it was one of our other friends back home that had found the link and sent it to us, so that's how we found out.
Alright.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Alright. But what made you decide to take this course?
I mean, overall, Doug and I were tired of our jobs back home, and we just wanted something new and different to travel. And so we kind of just started researching, and the friend sent the link, and we're like, yeah, let's just go for it.
And both work and travel at the same time.
Exactly. Yeah.
See. So, what advice would you give anybody who considers taking this course? Any suggestion?
Yeah, I mean, make sure to keep up with the coursework. If you get behind even by a day, it's really hard to get back on track. So just really try to keep up with it. Ask a lot of questions, you know, make sure you get feedback and kind of understand what it means so you can try to improve yourself and be better at teaching.
Great. And so what are your plans after, you know, after you finish this course? So basically traveling, or you're probably going to get a job somewhere?
Yeah, hopefully get a job somewhere. Not really sure exactly where yet, but I'm going to be staying in Bangkok and kind of see where it goes from there, I guess.
Take it slowly.
Yeah.
Thank you again for listening to.
Yeah, thank you.
Quite a lot, Henry.
Hey, Nan.
How are you today?
Great, how are you?
Great. So how long have you been in Thailand already?
I've been in Thailand 1 month.
1 month?
Yeah.
So basically for the course?
Yep, just for the course, yeah.
Wow. That's intense. So tell me, what do you enjoy the most from this course?
You know, I think I read a lot of things about the course. I loved how much actual like hands-on teaching practice we got. I think we were talking about it today. We had over 6 hours of practice, and yesterday we were at a sort of more rural school getting to teach younger kids. I've been in a couple nights a week getting to teach adult or like teenage classes. So it's just been a lot of really good practice teaching.
Great. And apart from that, do you have any, or have you encountered any difficulties in this course, during the course?
It wasn't a difficulty so much as I didn't expect that we'd have kind of a lot of work outside of class for this course. We had a lot of like reflections and journal writing, and it was all really helpful, but just because class was done in the morning didn't mean I was finished with work. I would go home most days and have to do, you know, quite a bit of stuff to prepare for the next day.
So it's hectic.
It was hectic. Yeah, it was busy. Yeah, it was really busy.
Could imagine. So how long, where have you heard about this course?
You know, I found it online when I...
coincidentally.
Yeah. Coincidentally, yeah. When I searched for kind of this kind of certification, online, this company and then a couple other companies came up, but I went through and read the reviews.
I emailed with kind of the customer service people in charge of each program, and this was the program that really kind of stood out to me in the reviews. Their people got back to me like right away, and they had good answers to my questions. That's why I ended up choosing
it. Good
feedback.
Yeah. Confirmed.
Yeah.
So basically, that what made you decide to take this course?
Yeah, pretty much.
Or any other reasons at all?
You know, I've been teaching for a while, and I knew I wanted to try teaching internationally, and so that's why I kind of decided to do this kind of program. But it was really out of the online reviews helped me pick this one.
Great.
Yeah.
So what advice would you give anybody who considers taking this course?
I think definitely come here with enough time to settle in before the course starts, because I came like the day before, and it was the first week was kind of stressful. And then definitely make sure you're coming in with the kind of the mentality that you are going to be working and you are
self-adjustment.
Yeah, be ready to participate, be ready to come home and get the work done, and you know, you're in a teaching course, so make sure you're here to do that. But they, the trainers are all really great at kind of leading you and helping you, and there's really no awkward adjustments or anything.
Great. So what are your plans after, you know, finishing this course?
Yeah, I'm still trying to figure that out. I know I want to try teaching here in Bangkok, so I'm kind of in the process of applying for jobs and making sure my resume is up to speed.
Just from like from school or secondary school?
Probably secondary school. I think it'd be great to work with adults too and teach in, you know, like maybe some night classes or kind of whatever job I can get teaching, just to keep building on the skills we covered in this course would be great.
Plus, when you're passionate in it, I think. It'll be easier.
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Well, thank you again for this interview.
Yeah, thanks.
Maybe how are you today?
I'm well, thank you. How are you?
Great, myself, thank you. How long have you been in Thailand already?
I've been in Thailand since the beginning of the year.
Beginning of the year? What are you doing here?
I've been studying.
Studying?
A little bit of language and studying to be a teacher.
Exciting. And where are you from again?
I'm from the UK.
From the UK.
Yeah.
Where exactly?
I will say London. It's
London.
Just next to
London. I see. So, what do you enjoy the most from the course?
I think what I've enjoyed the most is we've all got on. We've all been my compatriots, my comrades. We've all we've had a bit of a laugh. It's been good. We've been a good group, and that for me is important. It's key.
Experiencing this
just the relationship I've had with my peers, that's been really important. So that's what I've enjoyed. So when it gets tough or we've got problems, you know, we're all in the same boat, we're all, you know, we've all got the same goal to get through the course and study. So yeah, we've had a laugh and we've had a joke, and it's been good fun.
Sounds great to me. What about
difficulties? Well, because it's quite intense. Quite an intense course, so yeah, lots of scratching of the head and can I do this and multitasking.
Yes.
Trying to work out I've got to do this, I've got to do that, and for me that was quite stressful, but it was good. I think it's good to push yourself, so it was tough and it was quite stressful, but it was good.
It was worth it. That's
so
the word.
It was worth it.
Yeah, so what have you heard about this?
You know what, I just went online and did sort of TESOL in Bangkok, and I saw the Chichester website, and I think I made a decision pretty much on the spot. Pretty much, yeah. The website just looked very organized, the course looked structured, there was some great feedback, and I was like, I don't think I have to go too far, it's just a college looks the place to go. So it was literally like that.
It's a click.
Yeah, it was. It really was.
Yeah.
Wow, great. So what advice would you give anybody who considers taking this course?
What advice? To basically focus in on it. You basically give up a month of your life and focus in on just learning what it's like to be a trainee teacher. I think it's you definitely need to focus, for sure. Don't take on anything else outside of the month that you're here. Just really focus. Just focus your attention 100%, because there's quite a lot of work to do.
Does it remind you of a college life where
you know what, this is really something quite particular that I've never done before. I've studied before, but this has been intense because we've covered so much ground and done so much in 1 month. It just feels like taking a year's course
and just
stuffing it all into 4 weeks.
Wow.
Yeah.
I see.
So yeah, just be prepared to have a beginner's mind, be very open, be prepared to roll up your sleeves, and yeah, just to work, but also try and enjoy it as well. I mean you will enjoy it, but you know, you've got to work hard, but enjoy it as well.
So what are your plans after?
I really don't have any plans at the moment. It's just it's the last day of the course. I just think I need to go away and reflect and really think about the next step. And I'm not sure what that next step is.
Would it be teaching somewhere in town?
I'm not sure. It's a case of, for me, it's been very intense. I need a few weeks. Yeah, just to think about, just to reflect, because that's been key here. It's been about reflection. And I need to reflect and think about, you know, my own skills, capabilities, and the possible opportunities of where I could see myself and what I could see myself doing. So, yeah, I'll work it out in the next few weeks, the next few months.
I see. That's great. So, good luck with that.
Thank you very much.
And thank you for this interview.
Pleasure. Thank you. Cheers.
Hi, Chris. How are you today?
Good. And you?
Great. Do you mind telling us where you're from?
I was born in Panama, but I have Costa Rican nationality as well.
Wow, that is something else. Yeah. So, how long have you been here in Thailand already?
2 months.
2 months?
Yeah,
okay.
2 months.
It's been good so far?
Yeah, I really like Bangkok in Thailand.
No problem adjusting yourself to Asia?
No. I was living in Egypt, in Cairo, so
it's pretty.
Yeah, so it's not a big change.
Alright, so you've been traveling around a bit already.
Yeah,
I see. So, about the course, what do you enjoy most on the course here?
I think we have a good environment, atmosphere, and the learning techniques that the teachers use, it was very useful actually, so I really learned a lot.
It helps you
a
lot.
Yeah.
Okay. And any difficulties that you have encountered here?
Well, I think most of all the, well, we had a lot of material to learn, but I think the difficulties I faced was about how I was forcing myself too much, I think. I was pushing a lot to just do the best for me and for my learning experience. So I think just take it easy. Right now I'm just trying to, like, this is the last day, so I'm trying to relax a little bit.
Great. Wow. Where have you heard about the course?
Actually, I was just online looking for options, and then I came across it.
Just like everybody else.
Yeah.
Bam, online.
Yeah. Good.
Okay.
Yeah, teachers, I think, has good advertising and a good, like, Facebook page reviews.
That's great. Wow. And that helps you decide to take the course here.
Yes. At the end, it was closer to my house. I'm living just 5 minutes
from here.
Yeah, from here. So I was like, oh, okay. I think this is the
good, good location.
Yeah, good location, and it was just I just thought it was good for me. Just it was there for me. So
overall.
Exactly.
Okay. So, what do you have any advice that you think you would give to, you know, anyone who considers taking this course?
I think you need discipline, good organization skills, and you need to learn from your mistakes. And you, of course, need feedback from your colleagues and from the teachers. And you have a lot of feedback here. So I think you just learn every day, try to make the things better each day and just try to relax and don't force too much and do, just
yeah.
don't put a lot of pressure on yourself, because I think everybody hears because of learning experience.
Yeah, true. So what are your plans after you finish the course? Do you plan to do something or go somewhere?
I'm just going to stay here and I have a break with my husband. Well, my husband has a break in the end of this month. No, next month, sorry. So I'm just going to, I think I'm going to do a summer school, just 2 weeks, and then I'm going to just look for a job. Like a stable job. Yeah.
Like as a teacher?
As a teacher, yeah. Yeah, I'm going to keep on just doing
your love on that. And welcome.
Thank
so
you.
Thank you again for taking this interview.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
you. Welcome. ถ้าคุณสนใจเรียนภาษาอังกฤษที่ชิชเตอร์สามารถดูรายละเอียดเพิ่มเติมได้ที่ลิงก์ใต้ในวิดีโอนี้ค่ะ
If you would like more information,Please click the link below this video for address and phone number.
ค่ะ สวัสดีค่ะ